Hello everybody and welcome to the Tech Corner. In this edition of the show, we'll talk about how to transfer flight tracks from ForeFlight and display them in Google Earth. The agenda of the presentation would include a tutorial on how to export track logs from ForeFlight in the form of KML files and how to display those tracks in Google Earth for flight analysis or simply bragging rights. In order to take full advantage of this tutorial, you must satisfy a few prerequisites. You must have a subscription to ForeFlight. All levels would support track logs and breadcrumbs functionalities. You must have flown with your ForeFlight recorder activated at least once. After all, you need to have something to display. You must have Google Earth installed on your computer, Mac or PC. I think Google Earth works identically, but for this tutorial, I would use Windows-based PC. You must have email account accessible on your computer and on your iPad. I figured that the easiest way to transfer small files from a mobile device to a computer is usually just emailing them to yourself. So if you have your email access on both devices, you are set. Go to your iPad, click and open ForeFlight the way you usually do, and then pay attention to the bottom bar where all the icons for different functionalities are located. Click on More, and after you do that, you will see a menu that shows additional functionalities that are not visible on the original bar on the bottom. So one of those functionalities is track logs. Click on it. That would take us to the track log interface. When you first open it, what you see is a list of all of the tracks that are recorded by your subscription. Keep in mind that these are not just tracks recorded on this specific device. Any device linked to your subscription, when it's used to record tracks, would eventually sync them with all of your other devices. So for our example, let's just select the first flight. This is the one that I flew a few days ago, and it's interesting enough for the purpose of this tutorial. Click on it, and then you enter the full interface for track analysis. And in fact, I really like this interface. It's quite robust. It gives you plenty of functionalities to look at your tracks. And you can see, since my flight included touch and goes, the first portion of the flight was you can see the speed and the altitude. They go up and down, up and down, and up and down, indicating that I was really doing touch and goes. And then the second portion really shows it was more like a normal flight, where I went to the training area and did some maneuvers. Now, how cool would that be if we can put this already interesting track into Google Earth? To do that, we need to export the file containing all the information and import it into Google Earth. So, to start the process, click on the export button, which is located at the top right corner. The menu that appears would ask you how to send the track out, how to export the track. Well, select mail. Why mail? Well, as I mentioned, you have plenty of other options, but for me, emailing the file to yourself is the easiest one, the most simple one. Click on mail, and then select KML file. This is the version of how we're going to export the file. Once you click on KML file, the full interface for email would open. Make sure you type in the correct recipient, most likely yourself. The system should take care of the sender. You can check the subject line if you have a specific track and you want to notify yourself, hey, I'm exporting track, such and such track. And this is actually very useful if you have more than one track exported at the same time, because if you see the way ForeFlight names the tracks, it's very confusing. Humans can just read them and say, oh, I know what that track is. So give yourself a good subject line so you can find it easier once you receive the email on your computer. Click send, and with that you are done with the mobile device or your iPad. Then go to your computer, download the file. I usually use Chrome and Gmail. After you download the file to a folder where you have created for your tracks, I have one called my favorite track logs, you want to see an icon, and this is the track that I just exported. If you double click on that track, what's going to happen is you will trigger the activation of Google Earth, and that track would be populated, all the data would be displayed in Google Earth. And now that Google Earth opened and displayed the data from our track, we can see that sometimes we just have to be patient. The computer is doing very hard work to display all of the imagery from satellite pictures and all this complex 3D geometry, but eventually you're gonna see your track. Now, if your track is very long and you probably travel from to a distant airport, you may have you may be zoomed out a little more. But in our case, it's just a local area. Now, the track by itself, it's very nice, but we already saw the overall. Let's go see details. I can zoom at the airport where, as I told you earlier, I was doing touch and goes, and you can see my tracks. A couple of times the tower asked me to extend downwind with aircraft approaching, and then the rest of the times I was just given free rein of the airport, very short approaches and all this good stuff. And in fact, I actually even did the 360 here. Using mouse controls or keyboard controls, you can pan and zoom on your track to analyze it better from different angles. And if you just want to follow the track, just pan around Google Earth itself. I'm not gonna spend time concentrating on the various controls. There are much better tutorials out there for that. So coming to this area, this is where I usually like to do my vertical descents. I like the area, I know the altitudes and everything. And you can see that this was it wasn't very dramatic if you look at the track, although it was quite enjoyable in the air. Notice how the lines are getting closer and closer together. That means that my ground speed, which was based on a GPS, and that's what ForeFlight captures, my ground speed was coming almost down to a zero. So this is one way to determine how fast you are moving. And yeah, you can just take a look around, zoom, just pan and zoom around your track. You can see here I went to the Castaic Lake to see the people having fun with the boats. I circled around, eventually came back. So let's say you would like to grab this area and you're so proud of your maneuvers, you want to show it on Facebook. So how would you do that? Well, I use a program. First of all, you can use many programs. Let's just say that the snippet tool in Windows 10, it works very well. But I like a tool called Jink from a company called TextMate. And in this case, if I open my capture tool, which is pretty much a framing tool, you can put a frame around any image on a screen that you can capture, and you capture the image. You can even put text, something like awesome flight to Castaic Lake. There you go. And you can put it right there. Maybe you can even, anyways, you can play with your image, do whatever you think is necessary, use your imagination, just have fun. So, we started from ForeFlight, we came to Google Earth, we analyzed the track in Google Earth, and finally we grabbed a portion of the track on our snipping device or snipping tool. You can save it to disk, you can save it to memory, so you can directly paste it somewhere, whatever approach you'd like to take. There is no right or wrong here. So, thank you for watching. Please subscribe if you think that this is a kind of video you'd like to see more of. And I hope this was really helpful to you. Thank you again, and goodbye.